one of the education interns here at the Wetland Center, and today I am going to be showing you a model. Now, a model, of course, is a smaller version of the real thing, and they have limitations. Now, do we know what a wetlands is? It is kind of just what it sounds like. Wetlands is a place that does have water, or most of the time it will have water. That's why it got the name wetlands. Now, here we have a model of a wetlands, but it's a lot smaller. And as you can see in our pen, the blue is going to represent the bay, while the green section is going to represent the land. Now here we can say that this is Baytown, and this is one of the bays that surrounds Baytown. Now on this model, we see no wetlands, while on this side, we actually see the wetlands. And the wetlands is this grass here combined with the sponge. Now, one of the types of grasses that we actually see in a wetlands is called smooth core grass. And later on, you will get to see that type of grass. Now, for the video, I am going to be showing you how a wetland actually works, okay? Now, remember, we have limitations whenever we're using a model. One of the things, of course, is that this is not real grass, right? So it's not going to act like it, but the sponge is going to give it that same structure or something similar to where we can see the same effect. Now, on my pen that does not have a wetlands, I am going to add the soil so we can see what happens whenever it rains. Now, here we have our soil, and now I'm going to add some of the pollution that we get to see all around our roads. And the pollution, again, is represented by the red food coloring. Well, on this side, we have our wetlands, we have our mess, and then here, I'm adding some of that soil again. And more of the pollution. Now, we're gonna see how wetlands actually work whenever it rains. Now, I'm gonna make it rain on both of the pens. On this pen here, the one without the wetlands, as it starts to rain, you're gonna see that it just runs off, nothing is stopping it, and it goes all the way down to our bay. So we're seeing the red food coloring get down there, as well as all of our soil. Now on the pen that we have our wetlands, we can see how we're not seeing any water hit our bay so far. Now, at this point, we're seeing some, but not anywhere near as much as the one that we're seeing on the other pen. So on the pen without the wetlands, we saw how all the soil managed to get to the bay. And on this one, just a very small portion of it. Now, are we seeing any dirt on the wetlands? If you look clearly, there's only a little bit, okay? Now, once I remove the sponge and the grass, we're gonna see how wetlands actually work, okay? So if I remove the wetlands, we see how it trapped all of that soil. So wetlands actually stop erosion. And what is erosion again? Do any of us know? Erosion is whenever, okay, did we think about it? Erosion is whenever the sediment erodes or gets moved down, okay? So we saw how it actually stops. So we're not seeing any erosion. And if I squeeze the sponge, what do you think we're gonna get to see? Okay, remember, I put some pollution at the top and some water. So the moment that I squeeze them, you can actually see that the water came out red. So that also tells us that wetlands filter the water and they prevent the pollution to getting to our base, okay? And again, if you can see this clearly, you see some of the red coloring at the bottom. Okay, if we got to see that, again, that proves that wetlands filter the water so we don't get all that pollution. And again, we're seeing the erosion that it prevented with, again, the wetlands, okay? Now, that is just one of the ways that wetlands can prevent us. Now, whenever we get hurricanes and any tropical storms, the root systems of the plants that we have in the wetlands also prevent the erosion, okay? And the way that that works is just because they live in the wetlands, they have expanded root systems, and I'm gonna kind of show you that with my hands. So the roots, normally, they just kind of interlock, right? Well, If you were to try to pull your fingers apart, that's how the roots actually make sure that the soil sticks together, okay? So that's why we don't see any of the erosion happen. And again, this is one of the reasons why wetlands are so amazing, okay? They prevent flooding because they slow down the water. We didn't see as much water coming down as on our first model. Here, the sponges absorb most of it, so we didn't get to see that. The other thing that they do, they filter the water. And last but not least, they also prevent erosion, okay? So next time that you go around Baytown and you see all beautiful wetlands, tell them thank you, because again, they're helping us with all of these different resources.